Gentlewoman from California is recognized for 3 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and let me thank my colleague, Mr. Smith, Mr. Royce, and Mr. Engel for their leadership on this resolution. I rise in support of H.R. 780, urging respect for the Constitution of the Democratic Republic of the Congo in its democratic transition of power in 2016. Simply stated, the resolution calls for the United States President to use targeted sanctions to address the blatant disrespect for the people and the Constitution of the Democratic Republic of the Congo, as evidenced by the current president of that country, Joseph Kabila. By supporting this critical resolution, we are helping to support the constitutional rights of the citizens of the DRC. This massive and extraordinarily mineral-rich country is home to approximately 80 million people. Were it not for the consistent absence of democratic and economic good governance, this beautiful country would serve more fittingly as the economic center of gravity for sub-Saharan Africa's Central Africa region, as opposed to being seen at the center of political impunity, increasing human rights concerns, and predictable intra-regional tensions. The violence of the last decade has adversely affected not only the economically dynamic and creative culture of the DRC, but arguably affected those countries in the immediate region, such as South Sudan, the Republic of Congo, the Central African Republic, Rwanda, and Burundi. Despite a long history of authoritarian leadership of President Mobutu, a regime, unfortunately, that we supported, we know that the majority of the people of the DRC support a growing and empowered civil society. Over the past year, the country's expanding civil society successfully orchestrated a series of civic actions in support of constitutionally legislated elections scheduled for this December. For his part, President Kabila has used the past year to attempt to systematically to undermine the persistent efforts of civil society and opposition parties in support of presidential elections. While President Kabila's intention is to secure an extension of his presidential term and delay scheduled elections, the purpose of the resolution is to help prevent the impunity demonstrated by President Kabila and some DRC officials. The resolution calls for the President, working with African and European partners, to use Executive Order 13413 as amended to deny visas, freeze assets of the implicated officials, and monitor economic and security assistance for the country until the crisis is resolved. The resolution is a critical piece of legislation drafted to address a critical situation in the DRC, and once again, I thank the subcommittee chairman, Chris Smith, for his leadership on this issue. I yield my